Let us see what are the namespaces in C++. So here you can see a small program to demonstrate the namespaces. You can observe here on the slide. In the main program, we have integer variable value and value has assigned value 0. Then again, I am declaring double type of variable. This is double is a data type and a value, the same name. And I am assigning value equal to 0.0. Okay, it is a floating point number as I am declaring it as a double. But it will show error over here. Why? Because previously we have declared a value and we cannot declare again the same variable name. Okay, so it will give error as value has a previous declaration as integer value. You cannot declare it as double again. So what is a solution, or what if I wish to use the same name but the scope of the variable is different? So here we can see that more than one variables are being used without reporting any error. How? So this is because they can declare in different namespaces. So this is the first line, hash include iostream. After that I am saying using namespace standard. Okay, so this program will be stored in standard namespaces. Now within that program, how different namespaces can be used? So this namespace is a keyword in C++. This is indicated in blue color. Okay, so I am giving namespace first, and into brackets I am declaring integer val equal to 500. So I am declaring a val variable and assigning value 500 to it. Again, outside that namespace, I am declaring again integer val 100. Now, the scope of this variable is inside this first namespace. First namespace starts with curly bracket and ends with this curly bracket. And outside that curly bracket, I have a global variable, and with name of that global variable is again val. The data type is again integer. Inside main, integer main, again I am declaring a local variable integer val, same name again, equal to 200. Now what is scope of this declaration within the starting curly bracket to ending curly bracket? Within this, whenever I am saying val, it will be 200. Okay, when I come outside these brackets, the global value of val is 100. And whenever I am within this namespace first, the val contains value 500. Now let us observe what is done over here. These variables can be accessed from outside the namespace using scope operator. So this two colons is called as a scope operator in C++. Cout will display the contents on screen. Now I am saying first scope operator and val. That means I am telling this compiler to display contents of val which belongs to namespace first. So this is namespace first, in which what are the contents of value? Those are 500. So it will display 500. What if I have written something different? Let us see one more example to understand that. But before that, we will see the definition. Namespaces allows us to group named entities that otherwise would have global scope into a coding. So whatever we are writing, we are assuming always that the variables which are declared outside any function are the global variables. This allows organizing the elements of the program into different logical scopes. Okay, so this is a feature added in C++. It is not present in C. So it provides the scope. This is what the main requirement is. Syntax is namespace. This namespace is a keyword. Then you can give name to that namespace as you give name to the function. Starting curly bracket, inside this, the code declaration which need to be in this particular namespace, and the closing bracket. Let us see one more example. As I told you, here, we'll start from here, namespace NS1. So we have how many namespaces? 2. NS1, NS2. Okay. And within namespace NS1, I am declaring a function integer value which is returning 5. Within namespace 2, I am declaring a function value which will return a floating point number, and it is returning 2 into x. What is x here? 100. So 100 into 2, it will return 200. Okay, the previous namespace will return 5. In main function, I am displaying cout ns1. That means I am displaying contents of the execution of value function which is within ns1. So it will display how much? ns1 5. So see the output here. The first value is printed as 5. The second line, cout ns2 scope value. So it will jump to namespace 2. It will execute this value function and it will return the value 2 into x. What is x here? 100 into 2, 200. Let us check output over here. In output, we are getting value 200. Now, the third line, cout ns scope x. Now, I am accessing variable x from which namespace? ns2. So, jump to ns2. What is value of x? It is 100. So it will display 100. Okay. So this is how the namespace makes the difference. Okay. I assume that you will be able to understand the namespaces by these examples.